I'm Dr. Leila Masson. I'm a pediatrician and I work in Sydney in Australia. I have a practice where I see children with chronic illnesses and I use nutritional medicine and environmental medicine. So I always try to improve the children's diet and nutrition to help them be healthier because I really truly believe that diet is the most fundamental basis of good health. So I spoke today about the risks and benefits of a plant-based diet during pregnancy and also breastfeeding. We know that women have higher needs, nutritional needs when they're pregnant because they're growing a baby. So they need more nutrients, more calories. And the question was whether a plant-based whole foods diet can meet those requirements. And yes, it can. There's some of those nutrients women who are on a vegan or plant-based diet get even more of. So for example, folate and magnesium and fiber, they get more of than their non-vegan counterparts, and that's very beneficial. They also get more antioxidants, and antioxidants are particularly important in pregnancy because every time you create a new cell, there is a certain amount of oxidative stress, and antioxidants will neutralize that. And magnesium, for example, is really important in pregnancy because it reduces the risk of getting high blood pressure, preeclampsia, and needing, you know, to be induced and having the baby early. If you have good magnesium levels, you're less likely to get muscle cramps, which is quite common in pregnancy. And you sleep better if you have enough magnesium. So there's certain nutrients that women on a plant-based diet, whole foods plant-based diet, get more of, but there are also some that are really difficult or impossible to get from a purely vegan diet. And I think it's really important that everybody knows that. For example, B12. So vitamin B12 is produced by bacteria and you get it when you eat animal products. You don't get it from vegan products, unless they're fortified with it, but they're usually very small amounts in the fortified foods. So it is very, very important that any woman who's pregnant or breastfeeding or any child takes a daily B12 supplement. I think that's the most important message from my talk, that you need to take that B12 because we, you know, time and time again, we read in the press that a couple, you know, raised their child vegan, did not give B12 just because they didn't know, and the child got very, very ill or even died, you know, so veganism gets a very bad rap there. But actually, if you take the B12 and some other supplements, your child can grow up really, really healthily. So other nutrients that are really important in pregnancy that I think may be hard to get enough of from a plant-based diet are the omega-3 fatty acids. So that's EPA and DHA. They're essential fatty acids that make up a big part of our brain. And so while the brain is growing really, really fast, when you think of it, you're in pregnancy, the brain develops from one cell to the most complicated organ that we know in the universe. And you need all the ingredients to make that brain. And the brain is made up about 50 to 60% of fats. And about a third of that is those highly unsaturated fats like EPA and DHA. So we need to get them in the diet in order to produce that brain, grow that brain. And you can get those omega-3 fatty acids from algae oil. So it's vegan, it's healthy, it's not full of chemicals like fish oils. You know, fish oils can be very contaminated with mercury and other toxins. And algae oil is produced organically, so it doesn't have that in there, much superior. Another one is vitamin D. Vitamin D comes usually from the sunshine. When you're outside, the sun hits your skin and you produce vitamin D. But in the winter, in Northern Europe or in the Southern Hemisphere where I am, you just don't get enough sunshine and the sun is at an angle where it doesn't really produce vitamin D. So we need supplements. Some animal products have some vitamin D, like milk often is fortified with vitamin D. So non-vegans still get some in their diet and vegans don't. So you really, really need to take a vitamin D supplement, especially in the winter. Now, this is important not just for vegans, but probably most omnivores also need that. And then I was also talking about choline. Choline is one of the B vitamins that is very important for brain development. It's quite high in eggs, so people who eat eggs get big doses of it. And a vegan diet is much lower in choline. Now, it is controversial. there are people who think that choline is actually very pro-atherosclerotic, so causing more atherosclerosis, and then it's not so good to have it. We don't really have the studies yet to decide. So the vegan foods that contain choline are quinoa, tofu, broccoli, foods like that, and it is important for brain development. Then there are certain minerals that are really, really essential for thyroid function for the mother in the pregnancy, and we know that if the thyroid doesn't work well, the child's development can suffer. So that's iodine, zinc, selenium, and that's, again, I mean, you get some from animal foods maybe, but everybody is at risk of having low levels, not just vegans, also the omnivores, but it's very important to ensure that the pregnant woman, the breastfeeding woman, and the young child gets enough of those.